Hi everyone. So in the recent episode on the Neo-Hittite states, I mentioned a people and a language called Luvian, and several of you wrote to me wanting to know more about them, so I thought I'd quickly cover the topic in this program. During the 2nd and 1st millennium BCE, the people known as the Luvians were one of the largest, if not the largest, group of people in what's today Western and South Central Anatolia. They spoke a language which in Hittite texts of the time was called Luwili, a word that literally means in the language of Luwia. Today, we call this language Luvian, and its written form has been found in both cuneiform and hieroglyphic scripts. Though it's not known exactly just where the Luvians came from, most scholars believe that they migrated into the region from somewhere north of the Black Sea, perhaps as early as the 3rd millennium BCE. However, by the 2nd millennium BCE, they were widely dispersed throughout Anatolia. Along with their own inscriptions, much of what we know about them comes from Hittite language texts. According to these documents, they made up the primary group of the western lands of Arzawa, while in the south, they were a large percentage of the population in the areas known as Luka, Tarhuntasa, and Kizuwadna. Many scholars also believe that the kingdom of Wilusa, in northwestern Anatolia, where the city of Troy was located, may have also had a predominantly Luvian-speaking population. If true, then it means that the Trojans could possibly have been a Luvian-speaking people as well. Use of the Luvian language was widespread throughout the Hittite Empire. It could be seen adorning all sorts of monuments, seals, and was used extensively in religious and legal texts. In fact, many inscriptions of later Hittite kings, including Tuthalia IV, were exclusively written in Luvian and not the Hittite language, known as Neshite. What's interesting is that after the collapse of the Hittite Empire, Neshite more or less disappeared. However, the Luvian language, especially in its hieroglyphic form, was not only preserved amongst the various populations of Anatolia, but promoted as a royal language amongst the Neo-Hittite states that popped up in the northern Levant and southeastern Anatolia during the early Iron Age. The true reason for this phenomenon has puzzled scholars. Some believe that it may have been simply the result of various Neo-Hittite rulers wanting to keep, or at least appear to keep, some sort of continuity with the Hittite kings of old. It's also possible that there may have been an influx of Luvian refugees into southwestern Anatolia and what's today northern Syria after the fall of the Hittite Empire and the Bronze Age collapse of the 12th century BCE. No one really knows, but I hope that at least you now know who the Luvians were and have a bit more knowledge about the history of their language. As always, thanks so much for stopping by, I really appreciate it. If you learned something, or simply just enjoyed the video, please don't hesitate to hit that like button, because it helps the channel out a lot. You can also check out the History with Sai podcast, and follow the channel on Instagram, Facebook, and Twitter. Thanks again, and I'll catch you in the next episode. Take care, and stay safe.